to Insights, where we discuss a new topic in every episode. So the topic today is why North Korea is not such a bad guy. Rajesh, can you tell us a bit more about this topic itself?
Hi Ananya, it's good to be with you again. Yes, you know, I don't think North Korea is such a bad guy. I came to this conclusion when a few months ago I was having a discussion with a British colleague of mine, and she said, which country in the world do you think is the best? And I thought a bit and I said, it's very difficult to decide. What do you think? And she said, I think England is the best. So I said, why do you think it is the best? She said, well, we have democratic traditions, we have freedom of, you know, expression, we really care for the rights of people, and these rights are getting eroded in other democratic systems in Western Europe. So I think England is the best country. And I said to her, partly to provoke her, I said, I don't think so. In fact, I would say that North Korea is a better country than England. So she said, she was astonished. She said, how can you say that? Are you joking? How can you say that North Korea can be better than England? So I said, well, the thing is, if you look at North Korea, in a sense, is a victim of being close to China, the system that is followed there. It's a dictatorship because it's close to China, and China would not want a democratic country so close to it. So in a way, it's a kind of prisoner of geography. China will only tolerate other dictatorial regimes near it. So North Korea becomes a dictatorship. And I said, Kim Jong-un, he persecutes his own people, that is true. But he doesn't cause much damage around the world. Yes, he sends missiles over China, over Japan once in a while, and the Japanese get very upset, the South Koreans get very upset, but then they land harmlessly. He doesn't actually do any damage. This is just to show that, well, we can potentially create trouble. He doesn't actually do any harm. But England, together with many other Western countries, they actually do harm. Among the 10 top arms exporting countries in the world, 7 are Western. You have Russia, which is an important arms exporting country. You have Israel and you have China, but the other 7 among the top 10, they're all Western democracies. And they're exporting arms, and these arms are being used to create mayhem across the world. Look what's happening in Yemen. Look what's happened in Syria. So the Western nations are supplying all these arms, and this is creating bloodshed across the world. So who is creating more evil in the world? You can say that there are two kinds of people. Who will you call a good person? There's one person. He takes good care of his family. He's very kind to his wife. He's very kind to his children. But he goes and beats up his neighbors. He takes a gun and he starts shooting his neighbors. Is this person a better person? Or is the person who beats up his wife, who beats up his children, but is very nice to the neighbors? Who is better? So I said, you know, this is exactly the comparison between Mr. Kim from North Korea and Western democracies. Mr. Kim may be treating his own people badly, but he's not doing much harm in the world. But Western democracies, by exporting these arms, by focusing on the billions that they are earning, they are creating a lot of damage. They are creating a lot of bloodshed. And why cannot they stop exporting these arms? If you ask a Western democratic nation, what is the need for Britain to be sending all these arms worth billions of dollars to Saudi Arabia, which are used then in attacks in Yemen? They will say, well, if we don't supply the arms, somebody else will. Okay, that's a fair argument, but the point is that why can't you take a little bit of loss? You are a rich country. Why do you need to insist on making money? Why can't you sacrifice some income? There is no compulsion. Be a good person. If you consider yourself to be a truly great nation, then stop the export of arms. And when I say that Western democratic nations are guilty of this arms export. I don't mean to exclude Scandinavian countries. You'll be surprised. Switzerland exports a great deal of arms. Denmark, they provide radar and other weaponry. So the entire Western democratic system is complicit in this export of warfare, indirectly. The American Gunnar Myrdal, you know, he wrote a famous book called Asian Drama. In Asian Drama, he speaks about Asian attitudes towards cleanliness. And the criticism is valid. He says, for example, in India, Pakistan, and other parts of Asia, people will keep their houses very clean. They will be very clean personally in terms of hygiene. They will have their bath maybe twice a day. Their house will be very clean. But then they will throw their filth on the road. So he says, compared to the West, the Asians are really, you know, they're just concerned about their own family. They don't care about society. Now, this may be a flawed argument for two reasons. Number one, although there is definitely some truth to it, it's also a fact that because municipal systems are not well developed, there's no, you know, garbage collection outside the home that people did throw it because there's no municipal system to collect the garbage. But cleanliness is one thing. What is more important is this whole issue of armament supply. If your own system, as I spoke to the English girl, within England you have democratic rights, within England you have rule of law, but then, as in the Gunnar Myrdal's example, you keep your own house in order. All these Western nations are keeping their own houses in order, but they don't hesitate to export arms to countries who are involved in great conflict, to dictatorships in Africa. There is questioning, like in the British Parliament, there was recently questioning about the exports of weapons to Saudi, which are being used to kill innocents in Yemen. But that questioning is limited. The West is not capable of sufficient sacrifice for the planet. They talk about how we should all sacrifice for the betterment of the planet, but they have to take the first step. They have to first sacrifice some profit. What is this thing that if we don't supply arms, somebody else will supply arms? So in conclusion, North Korea is not such a bad guy.